last session we derived what is the force between two parallel current carrying conductors. That is the important 5-mark question. Okay, and we define what is the ampere from the force between two parallel current carrying conductors. Okay, now today's session we are going to derive what is the torque acting on a rectangular current carrying loop which is placed in a uniform magnetic field. If you take a single conductor, the straight conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it experiences a force. But whenever we place a coil, it will experience a torque. Now we are going to find what is that torque, and also we are going to understand what is the magnetic dipole moment. In the previous electrostatics, you already know what is the electric dipole moment. Here, through this, we are going to understand what is the magnetic dipole moment. Okay, so for that, here I consider a magnetic field, uniform magnetic field. This is the uniform magnetic field. It is represented with the B bar. In this uniform magnetic field, I place a current carrying rectangular loop ABCD. A, B, C, D. This is the field direction, and the current direction in the conductor can be, or loop can be considered like this. So this is the current carrying loop which is considered in a magnetic field, and length of the loop is L, and width of the loop can be taken as D. So I assume the current carrying loop is in a magnetic field in this manner. Okay, now this is the magnetic field B bar. Now whenever we place a conductor, then it will experience a force, but when we place a loop, then it will experience a torque. Now we are going to find what is the torque. Okay, now force acting on conductor AB and conductor CD. First we find what is the force acting on conductor AB and conductor DC. Here this force is equal to, what is the formula for force? B I L sin theta. We know the formula for force is B I L sin theta. This is the force acting on a current carrying conductor. But now when we are observing, this is the conductor and it is magnetic field. Conductor length and magnetic field both are parallel to each other. Means angle between the conductor and magnetic field is zero. Sin zero can be taken as zero. In the similar way, conductor DC and magnetic field both are anti-parallel to each other. Then angle can be taken as 180 degrees. So finally, sin 180 is also zero. So the force acting on AB and force acting on CD is zero. Why? Because those two portions are parallel to the magnetic field. In the parallel conductors, means a conductor placed parallel to the magnetic field, there is no force acting on that. Only conductor placing with certain angle, then only the force can be acting. So it is clear there is no force acting on conductor AB and conductor CD. Now we are going to observe force acting on conductor DA and conductor CD. Now we are going to find what is the force acting on conductor DA and conductor CD. So for that force is force due to DA. FDA is equal to, what is the formula? BIL sin theta. That is, what is the magnetic field here? We take B. Current through this one can be considered as I. So here B, I. And what is the length of the conductor DA is L. Sin theta. Sin theta is the angle between conductor and magnetic field. So here this is the conductor and it is the magnetic field. What is the angle between these two? Field and length of conductor angle is 90 degrees. So sin 90 is equal to 1. So force acting on conductor AD is BIL. In the similar way, force acting on conductor CD. No, conductor BC. Force acting on conductor BC also. This is the conductor length and it is the magnetic field. Both are in perpendicular to each other. Here also angle is 90 degrees. So here it is also BIL. So from this what we understand, the force acting on conductor AB and conductor CD is zero. Why? Because those two conductors are parallel to the magnetic field. Then force acting on conductor AD and conductor BC is B into IL, because those two are perpendicular to the magnetic field. And now we are going to understand what is the direction of the magnetic field also. And the direction of magnetic field is given by your right and left hand, Fleming's left hand rule. So now take the Fleming's left hand rule. I already explained in the last session. Thumb indicates force direction. The forefinger indicates this is the direction of the field. The middle finger indicates this is the current direction. Now I am going to place my thumb like this. See here. This is the current direction and it is the field. My forefinger pointing the field, my the middle finger pointing the current direction. Then what is the thumb? Thumb is into this direction. So here the force is into the direction. Here force is acting into the board. Okay, now this is the force acting on the conductor AD by the magnetic field. Thus direction is according to Fleming's left hand rule. It is given into the board direction. Now here also we are going to observe what is the direction of the force acting on the conductor BC. Here also we are going to obtain like this. So this is the middle finger indicates current direction, forefinger indicates field. Now what is the direction of the force? The force is outward. Our force is outward from the board. So from this what we understand, on this loop it is placed in a magnetic field, two equal and opposite direction forces are acting. So here two couple of forces are acting. The couple of forces are constrained a torque. Okay, now we are going to find what is the torque acting on this loop. Now see this, how this couple is constituted. Here one force is into the board, other force is outside from the board. So these two forces are acting in this manner. Okay, now from this the torque can be written as, the torque acting on the loop is force into perpendicular distance between the couple. Force into perpendicular distance between the couple. See here how these are exist. This is the force acting on conductor BC, means outward direction. This is the force acting on conductor AD into the direction. These two forces are acting like this. One is outward and the one is inward. The distance between these two forces are nothing but the width of the coil. So the perpendicular distance between these two forces is nothing but width of the coil. Width of the coil is nothing but A. Now from that what we can write, the torque tau is equal to, here I am going to write the torque acting on this loop, tau is equal to force. Both magnitudes are equal, that is BIL, and on this also BIL, but those are acting in different directions. One is acting into the board, other one is acting outward. So two equal and opposite forces are acting, then it constitute a torque. The torque tau is equal to force is equal to BIL into, what is the perpendicular distance between the two forces, is nothing but width. So that is B into I into length into breadth is nothing but area, where A is the area of the given rectangular loop. Now from that, the torque acting on a single turn rectangular loop is placed in a magnetic field is BIA. But whenever we place n number of turns, if the loop is having n number of turns, that is for n turns, when we take n number of turns of the coil, is placed, then the torque is equal to N into B into I into A. So this is the magnetic field acting on a rectangular loop which is placed in this position. Now if the loop rotated with an angle theta, if the loop is rotating with an angle theta, means see here the diagram is, it is the magnetic field. We draw there. This is the magnetic field. Now the loop is rotating with certain angle theta. Previous loop is taken like this. If the loop is rotating in this manner, means I am going to draw the loop. See this. If the loop is rotating, now this is the axis. Means in the previous loop is like this. Whenever the loop is rotating with certain angle, then how the torque is acting, we are going to find. Now in this case, this is A, B, C, D. And here it is the magnetic field. And it is the area vector. This is the area of vector of the loop, because the torque acting on the loop is depend upon its area. So whenever we place like this, the area vector and magnetic field both are making 90 degrees. But whenever it is moving in this manner, the area vector and the magnetic field both are having certain angle theta. Now again, this is the length of the loop and it is the width of the loop. Now we are going to find what is the torque acting on that. So here we know that, what is the formula for torque? Again, here on this conductor, the force is acting in two directions. We already discussed in previous. And on this conductor, the torque is acting outward direction according to Fleming's left hand rule. Now the torque is equal to, what is the formula? Force into perpendicular length. In the previous case, the distance between these two forces is, we easily calculated, that is the width. But in this case, the distance between the two forces is not width, that is changed. See how it is changed here. This is the force on AD, it is acting into the board. This is the force on BC, it is acting outward from the board. See here, when we are observing, this is the width. See here, this is the width, but it is the perpendicular distance. Clearly understand, this is the inward force, this is the outward force, it is the width B. See, this is the width B. Now we have to find what is the distance between these two forces. The distance is nothing but, here angle can be taken as theta, opposite side. So this is become B sine theta. Okay? In the previous case, when the loop is in this manner, we easily calculate, that is, distance between the two forces is, perpendicular distance is beta. But whenever it is changed like this, now the distance between the couple is changed. The distance between the couple is nothing but B sine theta. Now the torque is equal to B into I into L into, what is the perpendicular distance? B sine theta. Now this is, tau is equal to B into I into, what is L into B? L into B is nothing but area. So it is B I A sine theta. Here we know that the B and A both are vector quantities, and this is the torque due to single turn coil. For n turns can be taken, now the torque is equal to B into N into I A sine theta. Now see here, this is A, this is B sine theta. A B sine theta can be written as A bar cross B bar. But here we have to know one term. N into I A is known as magnetic dipole moment. Remember that. We have electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment is charge into distance between the charges. Charge, magnet of charge into distance between the equal and opposite charges, that can be called as electric dipole moment. Here magnetic dipole moment is nothing but current into area of the loop is known as magnetic dipole moment. See this, N into II is magnetic dipole moment, where area is a vector quantity, then magnetic dipole moment is also a vector quantity. Now here this is B into M sin theta. So finally, this is the magnetic field. This is the torque acting on the loop which is placed in a magnetic field. Now finally we are going to write the torque tau bar is equal to AB sin theta, means A bar cross B bar, that is M bar cross B bar. This is known as torque acting on a magnetic torque acting on a rectangular loop which is placed in a magnetic field. See here, it is similar to the torque acting on a loop which is placed in electric field. What is the formula for torque acting on a loop placed in electric field? Is P bar cross E bar. Here P bar is electric dipole moment, E bar is electric field. In the similar way, the torque acting on a rectangular loop is tau bar equal to M bar cross B bar, where M is the magnetic dipole moment and B is the magnetic field. So like that we are going to derive the torque acting on a rectangular loop which is placed in a magnetic field. Initially it is in this position, magnetic field is B into IA. When it is moving with certain angle, then the torque is B into I into A sin theta. Here N into I into A is known as magnetic dipole moment. So in place of N into I into A, substitute M. So this is in the form of AB sin theta, that is written as A bar cross B bar. So finally, the torque acting on a loop is tau bar is equal to M bar cross B bar. Now practice that one, that is the torque acting on a rectangular loop. In the next session, we are going to derive how a circular loop acts as a magnetic dipole. Means previous we know that a positive charge and a negative charge placed with a small distance, it is an electric dipole. In a similar way, when we take a circular current carrying loop, it acts as a magnetic dipole. Okay, in the next session we are going to observe how a circular current carrying loop can act as a magnetic dipole, and also we derive magnetic dipole moment of a electron which is revolving in its circular path. Okay, in the next session we are going to show that how a circular current carrying loop acts as a magnetic dipole, and the magnetic dipole moment of a electron revolving in a circular path. Thank you.